Is my tap water safe to drink? Is it appropriate to cleanse the body by fasting from time to time? Is vitamin D going to save my life? Is it enough for me to take 4 times the regular dose? We have all probably had one of these questions we've always wanted to know the answers to. But now you don't have to stay awake at night wondering, is it possible for diet soda to kill me? We've got your answers to all these questions. So stick around, you don't want to miss this one. Number 1. Is it possible for diet soda to kill me? In the early 1960s, a new kind of beverage took the stage. It was not a unique shape or color or flavor. The answer to the question is no. It was diet soda, and it was awesome. With fewer calories and less sugar, diet soda seems to be a healthier alternative to regular soda. Whether you're asking if it can cause cancer, the response is most likely no. Do you have diabetes? It isn't very certain. Is it osteoporosis? And it appears that the drinks could be linked to weight gain. Recent research indicates that drinking multiple diet drinks a day can weaken bones and lead to weight gain, but the reasons for this remain unclear. I do prefer real sugar, says respected nutritionist Marion Nestle, PhD, author of What to Eat and Food Politics. The other sweeteners are all synthetic and chemical, and there isn't much proof that they help people lose weight. According to a report published this year, the reverse is true. There's proof that the replacements interfere with the body's ability to register how many calories it's taking in, at least in rodents, which may lead to overeating. Number 2. Is my tap water safe to drink? Tap water will not kill you instantly, but over time, there are most always things in tap water that you don't want. Unless you have a private well, it comes from public treatment facilities, which are more closely controlled and supervised than bottled water. If you are going to drink tap water over the year, that is not a good idea. Some well-known brands such as Aquafina and Dasani are nothing more than tap water. While the water supply must now be filtered extensively, minuscule quantities of chemicals and pharmaceuticals can still be present. Consider installing a filter on your faucet to ensure you're drinking the purest water possible. The best way to drink water is to get a water filter combined with a KDF filter that takes out many metals. By doing so, you're going to get it fresh and newly cleaned. You should have purified water. Number 3. Is vitamin D going to save my life? Is it enough for me to take 4 times the regular dose? Millions of people today are deficient in vitamin D, and vitamin D is one of the most important fat-soluble vitamins that our body needs to stay healthy. This serves as our defense that protects our body. Taking high doses of vitamin D not only keeps bone healthy, but also lowers the risk of cancers of the colon, ovary, and breast, as well as diseases like diabetes and multiple sclerosis. Many of us don't get enough due to a lack of sunlight exposure. The sun causes D to be produced in the skin, or diets that exclude good sources of D, such as fatty fish such as salmon, mackerel, and tuna, and fortified milk and cereal. Although the recommended daily dose for people 51 to 70 years old is 400 IUs, most experts agree that they should strive for 800 to 1,000 IUs of supplementary D per day. However, if you're under 50 and get the recommended 200 IUs, the equivalent of 2 glasses of milk a day, and 10 to 15 minutes of sun exposure a day without sunscreen, a 400 IU supplement should suffice. Number 4. Is it true that I can't infect someone else for 48 hours after starting antibiotics? Yes, in most cases, though only if you had a bacterial infection, such as strep throat, rather than a viral infection, which antibiotics are effective against, according to Scavner. However, if you stop taking the drugs too soon, the bug can return. Additionally, if you do not finish the whole prescription, the remaining bacteria can develop antibiotic resistance, making the drugs ineffective the next time. Antibiotics are powerful medicines that fight bacterial infections. They either kill bacteria or keep them from reproducing. But antibiotics do not fight infections caused by viruses, such as colds, flu, coughs, and bronchitis and sore throats. If a virus is making you sick, taking antibiotics may do more harm than good. Number 5. Is it appropriate to cleanse the body by fasting from time to time? Fasting sets the stage for detoxification, but detoxification only happens after the waste accumulated in the body has been eliminated. As a result, fasting is an excellent way to kickstart a detoxification process. A short liquid fast or cleanse is perfect as long as you're in good health. But don't expect miracles, other than maybe a sense of personal achievement. Any physiologist can inform you that healthy lungs, liver, kidneys, and intestines do a great job of keeping the body clean without the help of fasting. That wraps up our top 5 health questions for today. Check out this playlist for more health and wellness advice. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss more videos of health and wellness advice and much more. See you in the next video.